Martin Tyler here for you, along with Alan Smith, of course. And our football today is from the Premier League.
Please welcome our visitors.
Southampton in action today against Tottenham. Tottenham trying to get back to winning ways after their draw, away draw against Manchester United.
Yeah, arguably the better team in that 1-1 draw. And I think they'll be the better team here.
Ryan Bertrand. Number 14, Oriol Romero. Number 22.
Very bad defence, the worst defence in the division. In contrast, the best defence. So whether that best defence will be challenged today and whether that record will still be intact at the end of this game, maybe not.
I think you've got to look at the two managers, because the home team manager here, I don't think he's worked enough on his defence.
Here's the Southampton team for you. Florin Gardosh plays with Maya Yoshida as the centre-backs. Harrison Reed starts, a player struggling for form. Shane Long is the main striker today. This is today's Tottenham Hotspur team. Hugo Lloris starts in goal. Toby Alderweireld starts. He's fit again. And at the point of attack, just one lone striker. One of the most southern football clubs in England, Southampton. This is a relatively new home for them, St Mary's Stadium.
I've enjoyed some good times in recent years when you think of Pochettino's season and then Ronald Koeman. Success he enjoyed. I'd be hoping they can continue that.
Lee Probert, the man in charge of this one. We're underway here with Spurs kicking off. Dele Alli. Got him out of a tight area with that back heel. Moussa Dembele. Here's Harrison Reed. Here's Pizarro. There's good progress with this attack. And that ball belongs to the goalkeeper. And cut out by the defender. Now the shot! Well, he's had a go.
You don't buy a ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
Pretty even game this for Spurs, but if they work hard at it, there's every chance that they can win it. Some potential in this move. Got the tackle in. Well, this is how this team can play. Sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out. Managers like players get called up by international setups, and of course national teams need coaches. Could he be a manager at an international level?
Well, I think he does deserve a chance. I think tactically he's proven himself to be quite astute, which is always fairly important at international level. He knows about players. He's a good man manager. I think you'd say that about him, so I think he'd do well.
Out wide, they were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively. Kieran Trippier, Eriksen. Here's a chance to attack. Tackle here. Here's Winks. Oriol Romeo. Here's Cedric Suarez. Sometimes, certainly in days gone by, an away draw was seen as a good result. I think once teams go to try and win the matches, they've drawn their last three, the visiting team, today.
Yeah, they have. I mean, they've been solid defensively. They're quite an organised side, which will help them here on the travels.
Oriol Romeo. They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack.
It's looking good, this move.
Got to be. They have taken the lead. Goalkeeper almost got there, but it wasn't a strong enough touch.
Yeah, he's annoyed with himself, isn't he? Having got a touch on it, feels he should have done better.
It's taken them half an hour to get it. They are now in front. Kieran Trippier. Toby Alderweireld. Dele Alli. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. Moussa Dembélé. Got the tackle in. Reed.
Good forward play from them.
A disappointing cross this time, I think. Eriksen doing well to keep the ball. Promising build-up until that challenge. Well, that's a poor cross, not well hit at all. Dealt with by the defending side. Cedric. Long. Redmond. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Pizarro.
Well, that's not so much an interception as a poor pass.
There will be a minimum of two more minutes
to play. That's of added time. Well defended, not just getting across, he thought quickly as well.
So it's 1-0 here as the half-time whistle goes.
Well, both teams have room for improvement, wouldn't you say? One goal in the first half, but just the one.
No, it wasn't great, and they seem to just be feeling each other out. And now that's been done, maybe they'll be a bit more adventurous.
Team's all set, and we're ready for the start of the second period. Pizarro. Tremendous understanding from these players. And here's the shot. He's in again. Not this time, not a second goal. The goalkeeper saw to that.
Yeah, well played the keeper there, because he was second favourite, and he did well to stop that.
Pizarro. Could be dangerous. Rushing it here. Moving from one side to the other. They've coped with it well defensively. Keeping the ball moving, that's important. Just needed to settle on the ball before striking the shot. Quick note for your diary. Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture
for Southampton. They'll be hosting West Bromwich Albion.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
Davis. Here's Alli. Southampton lining up a substitution now. Davis. In comes the challenge. Attacking well here. Jan Vertonghen. It's Harry Winks. Janssen. Very good passing from this team. And the cross comes in now.
As for Tottenham, their next game, Alan.
They're playing Watford in their next match. And I can only see one winner. I think now coast
through. Substitution for Southampton coming off the pitch.
It is a substitution now. To keep the team on their toes and to keep this lead, they hope.
Jay Rodriguez, building steadily here, keeping possession. Oriol Romeu. Going to be a change for Southampton, the sub's going to come on. Into the attacking third. They've got a great understanding, this team, just look at the passing. I think that's what the professionals call overplaying. Too many passes, possession squandered. That's a straightforward piece of work for the goalkeeper. Twenty minutes now remain. It's Tottenham who are going to make the change. Trying to find an opening. Panicking. Well, this is how this team can play. Sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done now, it's just a risk that they might get caught out. Well, it's been very even. That's the way it's looked to us as a game, and the possession stats certainly confirm that.
Yeah, I think if I had to guess at it, I'll probably go. It's been about 50-50 in terms of possession.
Coming onto the pitch.
It might be a good idea just to get a fresh player on and cement their position as they look to hold on to this lead. George Kevin Nkudu. It's looking good, this move. Tries the through pass. Tackle goes in. Here's Pizarro. Free kick. Can they hang on to this one-goal lead? The fans are trying to play their part in it happening.
Yeah, and it's the approach that the home team take that will be important. Do you go on and push for another, or just try and hold what you have?
Right from the beginning, we've never known which way this game is going to go, and it's kept its drama right to the last. Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left. Still 1-0 here, with the time almost up. What about this impacting on the next game?
Well, Southampton go up against West Bromwich Albion. And they have played well, they've stroked the ball around, and they'll be hoping to continue that.
Comes in with a tackle. Stopped emphatically, and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. Here's Yoshida. Cedric. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Stingley, please give a round of applause for today's man of the match, number 9,
Ross Barkley.
Jay,
he's had a good look and decided from what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes. On to the attack now. The shot's on! Score here, 1-0. A good part of the season has gone now, and they've lost, and they can't go on losing matches like this.
No, it can become a habit, a nasty one at this stage in the season. They've just got to try and correct one or two flaws that we saw out there.
It's a great result for the home side, particularly the improvement in their defending. That was the cornerstone of this success.
Yes, it was. They were much more like it. There was a determination throughout this side to turn around what has been a poor record.